seconds, and that will mean the end of 1970, the year of Kent and Cambodia and Apollo 13 and recession and Haynesworth and ecology and you name it. And maybe the year in which the young and the older began to look at each other straight in the eye and understand each other. We don't know, but 71 is a-coming. It's a-coming. The crowd is shouting more and more. The noise is really extraordinary. It'll be here any second when that light goes out. The light goes on to 71. Happy New Year!
Got on a plane in Portland, Oregon last night. He was just another passenger who gave his name as D.A. Cooper. But today, after hijacking a Northwest Airlines jet, ransoming the passengers in Seattle, then making a getaway by parachute somewhere between there and Reno, Nevada, the description on One Wire Service, Master Cooper. Search here, thinking the hijacker may have jumped off at the end of the runway as the plane touched down. But the problem is more complex. A daring parachute escape from a flying 727 somewhere between Reno and Seattle, Washington. Bill Curtis, CBS News. Fine. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to summarize for you the meeting that I have just had with the bipartisan leaders, which began at 8 o'clock and was completed 2 hours later. I began the meeting by making this statement, which I think needs to be made to the nation. America's public enemy number one in the United States is drug abuse. In order to fight and defeat this enemy, it is necessary to wage a new all-out offensive. I ask the Congress to provide the legislative authority and the funding.
It's being in tune with the greater universe, feeling that the earth has its past, present, and future. But my music actually is reaching outward, not being a part of the past, or the present, or the future. But rather, what I call an altered destiny, because I'm dealing with equations. And like most people feel, that the planet is doomed anyway.
The grave that they dug him had flowers gathered from the hillsides in bright summer colors, and the brown earth bleached white at the edge of his gravestone. He's gone. The grave that they gathered from the hillsides in bright summer color, brown earth bleached white at the edge of his gravestone. He's gone. He's gone. He's gone. He's gone. He's gone.
British plant finally capitulated and went decimal.
Thank you. September, 40,000. December, 50,000. April of 1970, 150,000. By the first of next month, May 1st, we will have brought home more than 265,000 Americans, almost half of the troops in Vietnam, when I took office. Every action taken by this administration, every decision made, has accomplished what I said it would accomplish. They have reduced American involvement. They have drastically reduced our casualties. And generations in the future will look back at this difficult, trying time in America's history, and they will be proud, proud, proud.
We'll be right back. make them, then you break them. Next thing you know, you're shot another year.
Looks like he's chewing on the handle of a screwdriver. That's the 5 o'clock Eyewitness News. Join us, won't you, at 11 tonight. We'll say farewell for 1971.